answer that for us tonight. We're going to look at Hebrews chapter 1, verses 1 through 3. Listen to what the infallible, inerrant, inspired, authoritative Word of God has to say about this Jesus. Check this out. Long ago, at many times and in many ways, God spoke to our fathers by the prophets. But in these last days, He has spoken to us by His Son, whom He has appointed the heir of all things, through whom also He created the world. He is the radiance of the glory of God in the exact imprint of His nature, and He upholds the universe by the word of His power. After making purification for sins, He sat down at the right hand of the Majesty on high. This is all about Jesus up in here. Amen. Answer that question. Who is this Jesus? He is our creator, our sustainer, and our deliverer. First it says He's our creator. Did you see it in the text? It said this, through whom He created the world. This lets us know that Jesus was the agent of creation. Yeah, wrap your brain around that for a minute. And speaking of your brain, He made that out of dirt. Yet it's capable of some astonishing abilities. This 3-pound mass of cells can store over 100 trillion gigabytes of information. The average iPad can only hold 32 gigs. That means you have the equivalent of 4 trillion iPads up in your head. Yeah, you look good and you're smart. And it can do some crazy stuff. It can handle 15,000 decisions per second, as in the case of the digestive process following eating. We can taste one part of quinine in a million parts of water. Our sense of smell can differentiate between a million different odors. I know that to be true. I don't mean a lot of youth camps in my day. Some of you little bros begin talking on that third day of camp, brother. Amen. You be all smelly coming up to me, preacher Tony, I just want the Lord to do a work in my heart. I'm like, brother, forget about it. Use some soap. Use it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
A million different odors. That's amazing. Listen. Our sense of touch can detect a projection that's only 1/25,000th of an inch high. Dust. Who did that? Where'd that come from? Proverbs chapter 20, verse 12 says, the seeing eye and the hearing ear, God made them both. You were made by Jesus. Amen. Yeah. Listen, it matters because Ephesians chapter 2, verse 10 says that we are God's workmanship, and that word workmanship means work of art. You see, you are a priceless, treasured work of art. And listen, there's no other artist's work that can come close to your brilliance. Nobody, man. You can go all the way back to the old masters or even the modern icons, and they can't touch how amazing you are. Listen, Michelangelo, Rembrandt, Van Gogh, Picasso, or even William de Kooning in his work called Interchange, which in 2015 sold for over $300 million. Listen, I don't care. You can take all of the accumulative wealth of all of those artists, and they can't come close to you. You are a priceless, treasured, original work of art made by Jesus.
Amen.
I'm just trying to tell you who he is, South Carolina. He just happened to be the greatest artist ever, and what he makes actually lives and brings him glory. He's our creator, but he's not just that. He's our sustainer. He's our sustainer. Did you see it? It's right there in your Bible. It says it right here. Watch this. Upholds the universe by the word of His power. Now listen, I was sitting home one night and I was watching a scientific television program, and they were boasting that they were hosted by what they called the most brilliant minds in the world. One of them was the infamous atheist Dr. Richard Dawkins. The other is famed physicist Stephen Hawking. I found that a lot of things they talked about was quite intriguing. But one thing really captivated me, they were talking about the fact that our Earth is tilted on its axis. This planet right now that you're on is tilted on its axis in space at a 23.5-degree angle. And the experts say that it should not be tilted at a 23.5-degree angle because becomes it physically impossible due to the mass distribution of water weight on our globe. But they're glad that it's tilted at a 23.5 degree angle because it gives us our four seasons. And if it was not tilted at a 23.5 degree angle, they said that the events that would unfold would be monstrously catastrophic. You might be out there right now folding your arms, looking at me going, I don't need God. Oh yes, you do. You needed to hold this world tilted at a 23.5 degree angle, brother. Amen.
Amen.
You know what the amazing thing is? He is holding it at a 23.5 degree angle, and he's not even breaking a sweat. And what does that mean to me and you about Jesus? It teaches us something about him. Listen, he specializes in operating in the realm of the impossible. Well, what does that mean to you right there? Well, you're right in your real life. Listen to me. Whatever you're going through, he can get you through. Whatever you're going through, he can get you through. And listen, if we can just chalk that off and brush that off with some kind of crazy little preacher talk, no. Don't you forget that, first of all, I'm first a human being. My name's Tony, I'm just a guy. But I'm going to tell you something, listen. This ain't no just little script I'm giving you tonight. Listen, you got to know where I'm coming from. My biological mother was a mentally insane homeless prostitute. I was born in a mental institution in McLean, Florida. She couldn't keep me, so they put me in a corrupt foster care system. And those people beat me, molested me, tortured me with burning cigarettes. And then when I finally got adopted, when I was one day shy of being 4 years old, listen, I got adopted. And those people, my adopted daddy was a raging alcoholic, and he used to beat me all the time and tell me that he wished he could never bought me or adopted me. And then my neighborhood was crazy. It was a crime-infested, poverty-stricken neighborhood. I watched a bunch of my cousins get shot. One of them got shot in the face with a double-barreled sawed-off shotgun. I'm not up here giving you some kind of little teacher talk. I'm up in this place testifying tonight that whatever you're going through, Jesus can get you through. Whatever it is, the Bible says comfort others with the comfort that you've been comforted. I'm here to tell you that this King Jesus has comforted my hurting soul more than one occasion. He's a sustaining God. He literally has the whole world in his hands. That means you too. And he's not just our creator, not just our sustainer. You know what else he is? He's our deliverer. Man, I'm going to tell you about how often this place wants it. This is crazy. He made purifications for our sin to be set down. Now, what's going on with that? Okay, check it out. God created humanity, Adam and Eve. They were created in the likeness of God. Therefore, they bore the image of God. They brought God glory in a very unique way, like nothing else can. And God's got an arch enemy, his name is Satan. And Satan is a glory stealer. That's why God kicked out of heaven. Wanted the glory of God. Now he slithers on over and he tempts Adam and Eve to do what God said not to do.